and so on. Hi, drummers. Hope you're well. Shout out to channel member Graham and also Malcolm and a load of others, in fact, who've asked about this groove. This is, of course, the main groove from Tears for Fears. Everybody Wants to Rule the World. Goes a bit like this. There are lots of different ways to play this, which you hear drummers, not least drummers playing with actual Tears for Fears, using. So we'll talk about that a little bit. Now, the most important thing with this, in my opinion, we should have said this was played by the amazing Manny Elias in the first place. There's also a shaker part going on. Don't let that confuse you. The drum kit part is separate from the shaker part. The main feature of this, I would say, is that hi-hat. I mean, obviously a big snare drum hit on 2 and 4, but the main feature is that hi-hat. Now, lots of people might say this is in 12-8 or 6-8 or compound time. Cool, you can count it as that. I actually just think of it as 4-4 and triplets. 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet, 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet. Being a simple drummer, you know, I get a nosebleed if I count to more than anything than 4. So 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet. And the hi-hat part plays on the first trip, and then on the 2, and then on the let. So in other words, every other note as you count your triplets, missing the first one, playing the second, missing the third one, playing the fourth, and so on. 1 triplet, 2 triplet. The second half of the bar is the same. Let's just play that hi-hat part a little bit while I count, and we'll just get a feel for that. So 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet, 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet, 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet. So that's the main feel of the thing. Now, the simplest version of this groove that you do see drummers playing quite a bit is just playing the bass drum on beat 1 and the snare drum on beat 2, the bass again on beat 3, and the snare on beat 4, which works great. That would sound like this. So you've got, in that case, 1 triplet, let 2 triplet, let 4 triplet, let 1 triplet, 2 triplet, let 3 triplet, 4 triplet, let 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet, let 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet, let 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet, let 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet. Now, you can play through the song, and there's a good little version, like I'm obviously, I bend the knee to the amazing Eric Moore. I saw a good version of him playing it, where actually, especially it's the where it's called Eric Moore Two Takes. The first one, he's pretty much doing that the whole way through, right? He's going. And it works great. I think he might actually be playing all the triplets on the hi-hat, but just accenting those notes instead, so. Which works great as well, but is more tricky. And I'm going to say that thing I always say, it depends where you're at with your drumming. That works great and can actually, I think, really glue it together and make it flow. So that works great, honestly. So let's just recap that. So this is now the simple hi-hat part, not playing all the eighth note triplets, just playing those accentuated notes. And we're going to play a bass drum on 1, a snare on 2, a bass drum on 3, a snare drum on 4. I'm actually going to talk it through as well. So it's kick, hi-hat on 1 trip. On the let, we're going to do nothing. On 2, we're going to play hi-hat and snare together. On the trip, we're going to do nothing. And on the let, we're going to play the hi-hat. 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet. 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet. which works great, right? You can happily play the whole tune like that. I'm pretty sure the rest of the band would be absolutely fine and they'd just crack on and that would feel great. Now, it sounds to me a little bit like when on the original recording, when it first kicks in, it's really hard to tell, honestly, exactly what's going on the bass drum. He might just be playing that at first. He might be playing a shuffle, or he might just be playing the first two bass drum notes of a shuffle. Let's think about that a little bit. So if we play the first two of the shuffle, which you do see drummers playing that with, that means you're going to be playing on the bass drum on the one and then the let and the three and the let. That would sound like this. Which again, works great, man. If the band started up and the guy went, I'd be like, yep, cool, that sounds good, that feels good, here we go. Obviously, if it grooves along and feels good, you're onto a winner there. So that would go kick, hi-hat, kick for one triplet, one triplet. And on beat two, it would go two triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet. Now, often when we do this in sessions, people at this point say, oh, I'm not getting it. Slow the F down, man. Like, slow down. I can't say that enough. Say it out loud. Like, do not attempt this. If it's not, like, just flowing straight away, do not attempt to play this unless or until you've shown your brain the information. Like, you don't bypass the bit where you actually learn it. It will be faster in the end to do this, right? Say it out loud. Kick, hi-hat. Kick, one triplet, one triplet. Okay, beat two, two triplet. So hi-hat and snare, nothing on let, nothing on trip and let, hi-hat on its own. One triplet, two triplet, one triplet, two triplet. As ever, good old myelination. Show your hands and your feet and your brain the information before you bring an expectation that it's going to perform this smoothly on your behalf. Let it digest. It might take a few sessions, man, to really sit. I find with a groove like this, when I first look at it, it's often quite confusing, wouldn't you, when you're first putting it in, because it hasn't settled in at that point. Do you know what I mean? That lovely myelination. I'll link to my video about myelination below. The myelination hasn't yet occurred. You need for that information to go in and then for it to really settle into your system. Give it some time, man. The first time through, I would say, for most drummers, it is for me anyway, the first time through is just the showing the information, right? You sleep on it, you come back, hopefully, maybe the next time, maybe 10 times later, maybe 50 times later, but with repetition, you'll sit down. But make no mistake, I didn't start by doing that, okay? That's such an important point that I just come up against again and again and again and again in the sessions that I teach. I didn't start by playing it at that speed. I started by going kick, hi-hat, kick, snare and hi-hat, nothing, hi-hat. That's a brilliant little version of it, like playing that. And then the full version, so to speak, which it appears that like the sort of current iteration of Tears for Fears, the guy's playing, and it certainly works great and appears to be what's happening. To my ears, it appears to be a bit, this feel seems to be a little stronger, a little bit later in the original. Basically playing the first three shuffled bass drums. So in other words, so essentially playing a shuffle all the way, not the one with the snare drum, I don't think, but all the others. And that would give you. that feel, right? Let's talk it through. Beat one. One triplet. Kick, hi-hat, kick. One triplet. Beat two.
Two
triplet. Now this time on the let, hi-hat and kick together, right?
So one triplet.
Followed by
two triplet.
And that's it. The good thing about this groove is the second half is the same as the first, right?
So one triplet, followed by
two
triplet,
followed by three
triplet,
followed by
four
triplet. So first half,
one triplet, two
triplet. Second half, same.
Three triplet, four triplet.
One triplet,
two triplet, three triplet, four triplet.
It's a really nice one, man. And obviously what's happening there is your kick drum is matching up with that lovely like bassy synth that's running all the way through as well. Makes it feel really good. So they're your options, man, and they all work great, I think. Playing just the one and the three.
One triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet.
Playing the first two swung bass drums. So playing one triplet. And playing those two plus the bass drum on the let of beat two.
One triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet.
Cool, man. And like I say, if you want to Eric Moore it up, it does seem like the actual Tears for Fears drummers over the years have not done this per se, but it works pretty well, which is actually play all of the triplets, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, with your right stick or lead stick on the hi-hat and just accent every other one.
So one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet.
Works pretty well. If you like, but definitely not not necessary on that one. So I hope that all makes a bit of sense. I can't stress it enough. For me, the big thing is not missing out the bit where you feed the information in the first place. My experience of working on this with a lot of people over a lot of years is if they do that, generally, they'll get it. And it all isn't confusing. And it's a case of just building the thing up step by step. Nice and patient, but you'll get there in no time at all, man. Double quick time if you're just consistent and persistent with it, versus people sort of trying to just do it all at full speed. Might work great, as always it depends where you're at with your drumming, but if it doesn't, then people often just get stuck, and that's when they say, this is hard, it's confusing, I can't do it, it all falls apart. You got to build it, man. Like all these things, you know, in my opinion, you got to build. So one last time, say that we're doing the full version. Say it out loud to yourself, right? Kick, hi-hat, kick. So evenly spaced, one triplet. Beat two, hi-hat and snare. Nothing, hi-hat and kick. Two triplet.
Two triplet.
Two triplet. One triplet, followed by
two triplet. One triplet.
What What a great feel, man. And it's really unusual, isn't it? Really, really unusual. And as soon as you play it, I should have done it as a name that drum tune, shouldn't I? So as soon as you play it, people are like, oh, I get what that is. Really, really cool. Really lovely one to have up your sleeve, man. Really distinctive, really unusual. So thanks to Graham and Malcolm. Shout out to them, channel members. And thanks to everyone who's asked about this. And thanks for watching as always. I really appreciate it. Thanks so much for all the lovely comments and for everyone watching. This channel has now passed 5.5 million views on YouTube. And I really, it's mind blowing, man. I have no intention of stopping now. I'll keep going and putting one of these up for you every day or as many days as I can. These videos will always be free. And yeah, thanks as always to all the amazing supporters of this channel. You can support this channel if you found it useful or helpful and you're in a position to via my Buy Me a Coffee support page, which I'll link to in the description below. You can do that two ways: by buying me a coffee, which is a single one-off show of support. So you go to the page and you go to where it says support. Thanks so much to all the amazing people who've done that and continue to do that. I'll shout out a load of those people shortly. And then otherwise you can become a channel member. So as a channel member for £10 a month, you become part of this channel, you help it to grow, you get an input into what videos appear, like Graham and Malcolm here. You get, if you want one, a customized practice plan, ongoing drum support. I'll put your practice plan together for you. I'll cut a free Zoom session as well where we put our heads together and we'll work that one out for you. And then you can send me practice videos anytime. I'll give you feedback, answer your questions via video response, and just be on hand to support you via email and video response as you go along. Plus you get members videos, extra stuff, notation and practice along versions, like you'll get for this, of the grooves and, you know, the tutorial type videos that I put up. Also, when I do full covers, you get a talk through video over on the members page, members side as well, talking through all the little drum fills and all the little moments, which some people find useful. And yeah, thank you and welcome to all the new members. And if that sounds like it would be of interest to you, details in the description below. That's via my Buy Me a Coffee support page. People always ask me, what is this Buy Me a Coffee? I haven't got my head around this Buy Me a Coffee thing. Buy Me a Coffee is a platform on which you can support a creator. You can either buy them a virtual coffee, which is just a donation to the channel, or you can become a channel member for sort of extra benefits and to become part of the channel and to help it grow and have input into it. Like I say, if that sounds like it'd be of interest, details in the description below. Thanks for watching as always. Good luck with your tears for fears. Let me know if I can help in any way and see you soon. Cheers.